All right, everybody, welcome back to another episode of Subnautica. I am Captain Beefy. And this is... I'm lost. This is the Game Vault. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel and ring that bell for notifications. Go ahead and leave a like on the video if you enjoy what you see. And don't forget to comment down below. Let me know what you think of the series so far. I am deeply screwed right now in this, in the depths of, this cave. I'm trying to get my way out. So at this point, I've resigned myself to the fact that I'm not going to make it. Although last episode, I did discover that I can eat those gel sacks I'm finding around. And there's one there. Two of them. They do get me a little bit of food and a little bit of water, which is great. Problem is not so much that as it is I just lack the power in this suit I'm wearing to get me to where I need to go. So most likely. There we go, that gave me a little bit of a bump. But yeah, most likely I'm not going to make it out of here. Which is... That sucks. What am I stuck on? Come on. So we're down to 20% power. Which is just awful. And we are a long way from our destination. Look at that, 900 meters. So the goal is going to be to get as close to that as possible before we have to abandon the prawn suit. And then we're going to die. Have to come back and recover the prawn suit as well as all of the stuff that it had. Now, here's the spot that's causing me all the trouble. And can I make it up here? See, there's just nowhere to latch onto to make that next leap up. So. Yeah, this is brutal. This is brutal. That was the jump that screwed me. So, we were able to get up into the tree a little bit. There's just no way we're getting up there, and I don't really see a way to do it, but, you know, we're going to keep trying until we run out of power. Oh my god, are we going to make it? Find something there. Okay. So let's try and get back up here. This was it, right? Yeah. Maybe getting up there. Holy crap, we might get a little closer.
Well, to avoid
power though. Thank you. God, if only we had a way to power this up a little bit more. How frustrating. Really? You're gonna mess with me? Get away from me. Suit drop, and we're going to go for the swim. Can always come back and recover that suit. This is awful. I mean, it's a possibility we might make it. We might make it. Getting those gel sacks was a huge help. Only 500 away. We got almost 200 out too. Providing nothing stupid happens, yeah, we might make it at this point. Let's see. That'll be great. And we'll go steal a couple power cells from the Nautilus and the grappling arm. Yeah, we're gonna make it. Holy crap. Okay, I didn't think we were gonna make it. Brutal, very frustrating. We did look around quite a bit down there. We did see there's another area that's a little deeper. So once we recover our prawn suit and get everything situated again, we will we'll do a little more gathering and whatnot, and then we will go back to the ship, see if we can upgrade the prawn suit a little bit more. So happy to get back to my ship. Alright, well, let's start with this. Goodbye. So much nickel. Those. Stressful than the trip up here was, that's for sure. Oh my god, I did not think we were gonna make it. I mean, I honestly did. I mean, yeah, granted, we got a lot of oxygen, we got the rebreather, all that good stuff. So, there, you know, there always is a chance, but I just felt like we were so far down and we were just in too much trouble. But here we go, we're fully loaded on food. Fully loaded on water, and we're about to repair this thing, power it up, and get the hell out of here. Thank you, gel sacks. Man, I'm glad I checked them. Let's get this thing just floating here. All right, well, let's place that one. Place that one. The upgrades in. Enter the prawn, and of course it wants to drop me. That's fine. this point, you go like this, and I believe... There we go. See, it pulls us up. There we go. Well on our way back to our ship, so that's great. Grappling hook for the win. Holy crap. Did I just... Yes, I did. Oh my God, this is annoying. Make it up without the grappling hook at this time, but there we go. That does give us enough time to regenerate while we hold on, let go, and then launch. And we are up. Okay. Well, thank goodness for that. Let's hop out real quick. Let's empty this storage. And let's get back in, because yes, we are definitely going to get more crap on the way back. We are not wasting this opportunity. I think one of them we're going to get is a silver. Let's get a titanium too while we're here. Why not? I think this is silver here. Yeah. We have so much gold, not a lot of silver, so it'd be nice to get a bunch of silver to bring home. Man, I really thought we were done. I thought I was, you know, I was coping at that point. I'm like, all right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to have to respawn. I think we would probably respawn at the Cyclops. If not, it would be way back our base. In either case, it would have been okay. If it was at the Cyclops, we would have gone back to the base and got the Seamoth. If it was at the base, we would have got the Seamoth and went to the Cyclops. But fortunately, we were able to pull it off and swim. Talk about going out with minimal equipment prepared. Wow. Self, do not leave without the arm again. That was bad. Okay. Perfect. But at least we know we can use gel sacks down here now to eat and drink, so that's cool. Is this more silver? Yep, sure is. Alright, let's take a look at what we got. Ouch. Oh, that doesn't hurt too bad. Alright, take out what we can.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
And let's grab this silver, because why not? We can make a butt ton of wiring kits if we need to save space. Go away. Crabby McCrab Pants. Come on. I guess that's it. All right, we continue our journey back. Look. Now we got room for a little bit more. But we're not going to do silver, though. We got plenty of that. What we don't have on this ship, though, is titanium. So let's grab a little bit more titanium. That's the root of all building. And I'm telling you what, we are coming back down here and we are going to build in that cool section. I think that's all we can carry, right? Yep. Fish. Seems like underwater Spider-Man with this thing, right? It is clunky, though, I'll tell you that. As far as grappling hooks and games go, very clunky. Alright, I think that's the way out there, so yeah. Let's get our butts in this ship. Can we do it? Oh, I tried. Try again. There we go.
Welcome on board. All systems online.
All right, so let's go ahead and put up the crap we're not going to use right now. Power in those, but there's something. Now let's grab out what we can. And get all this crap put up. Thank you. silver. Look at it all. Oh my goodness. Alright, we'll never have to worry about getting silver again, that's for sure. Or gold. Probably not copper either. Alright, I'll tell you what, feeling relieved? Marble melons are growing. If I remember correctly, we have to go. Yeah, it looks like that way. Alright, let's just get the hell out of here, guys. Captain Beefy has had enough. Okay, go to hell, Squid. Power's pretty low. But we'll be fine, I'm sure. Let's turn till we find our base. There we go. All right. Well, we got a long journey ahead of us. So what did we learn during these last two episodes, faithful viewers? Well, one thing we learned is to always bring your grappling arm when you are going deep, because that thing is going to save you and get your ass out of there. Also, it might not be a bad thing to bring a little extra. I mean, we brought some water with us, which was great, so that was good. A little food would have helped, but I mean, even one extra power thing would have been a big help. But without the grappling arm, it didn't matter anyway, because we weren't getting up and getting out. There was just no way that was happening. So we pretty much screwed ourselves with the grappling arm. That was the only thing, you know, were it not for doing that, the whole journey wouldn't have been that big of a deal. It would have been fine. So, that's what we learned. We also learned that gel sacks can save your life. I never would have thought. I was like, you know what? It is a plant. Maybe, just maybe, it'll do it. So it was just enough to keep me from dying. But most importantly, we found a way down to what looks like a volcanic zone. And I'm sure that area is going to, I almost should have left the prawn suit there, but I'm sure that area is going to be like the end game stuff. So we got a message coming through on the radio. Once we get home and get situated and all that, we'll address that, see what the message is. Does it lead us somewhere else and all that good stuff? We will make another beacon and try to relocate that blue area, maybe build just the basics of a base there, even if it's only a power supply, a fabricator and all that kind of stuff, just the very, very basics. We're not going to make it we're not going to put a garden outside and all that kind of crap. We'll try to avoid having to do that, but still, we'll do something, you know, it'll be something there. Definitely want to give that a try. Oh, home. I didn't think I'd see you again, home. I thought we were going to die deep in the depths of that cave. This is a relief. Like I said, the game doesn't, you know, doesn't freak you out with horrible monsters attacking and all that all the time. Although there is a little bit of that. It's mainly that dread of, oh crap, what did I do? You know? I don't have what it takes to escape this. I'm in trouble. So let's unload all these power cells that are spent. So yeah, look at that. We're down to 400 energy. Woo! Fortunately, of course, we've got a bunch more on the ship just ready to go. So let's also take some of this out of here. We're being kind of choosy right now because certain things I remember were needed more than others. Yeah, we got a ton of crap though. Oh my god. Alright, and back to our beautiful little base, our safe space here in the ocean. Hello, deep shrooms. Well, first things first. Also grab this salt and water. Yeah, it'll put a strain on things, but that's okay for now. I say things like power-wise. Gonna do some building. Be much more efficient if I knew what I was doing. Let's go ahead and get the power supply going again. Trips to clean this out, but we are gonna do it, let me tell you. Okay, so first things first, we need quartz. Thank you. more storage units. Very important. Find out. That kind of really doesn't belong in there anyway. All right. Fabricator should probably go in here. Just pop it there for now. I'll figure out a better location for that shortly. Yeah, look, our power's really low. Oof. Power cells really drain the ship, so that hurts. All right, back to what we were doing here. That radio, that can also go. We really don't need that in here. This should be strictly construction and storage. The radio, we can put... figure out a better spot for those things. Okay.
Seek fluid intake.
Okay, okay, okay. So first things first, let's take all of the manufactured stuff and oddities like that out. Put them all right in here. Screwed up big time. Hey, look at all these. Wow. So this stuff can all come out. It's gonna have to. Okay. it's a done deal.
Vital signs stabilizing. Sure, the water is being manufactured right now, so that's still going to be a little bit of a drain. Do have a little salt, but that's fine. We got room for one more of those, so I don't think. Here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go ahead and upgrade a lot of stuff into things like this, like wiring kits, copper wire, and stuff like that. We're just gonna make it to get rid of it, get it out of the inventory a little bit, and that'll help with things, and then we'll have it already made, so it'll be good. All right, so there's that. This one, here's some silver. We know where to get more silver if we need it. Man, we have so much nickel. Okay, so we don't need to make all of that, but we will make we'll make like 6 wiring kits. That'll be good. This will all be a big help when we do our next base too, so there's that. Alright, what else can we make? Thank you. we're getting a decent selection of things. Our knife is back on the vessel, so let's go get it. I just want to get more of those mushrooms growing.
Welcome aboard, Captain. All systems online.
Oh my god, there's still a bunch of crap. Let's grab it. Saw that moment of hesitation. Oh my god, so much nickel. Empty, 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 empty. Cool, I think we can refill this then and get these things growing again. So, don't mind me, I'm just consolidating them right now. Because we are going to be looking to see how many rods we can make.
looks like quite a few. All right, so 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14 rods can be made. So we'll need 28 quartz, basically. 14 lead and 14 titanium. Titanium, so let's throw all that together. And yeah, it's a matter of quartz. So much of it, and we're going to need a lot of it. Let's get this stuff organized. Still got butt tons of gold. And a nice amount of silver. Diamonds and cave sulfur, and then we got all this. Let's take this stuff, which we get from different creatures and sort of stuff, and find a new home for it. I guess we could stick it all in here with the silver. All right. So we got things kind of organized. Oh my goodness, that was tough. Journey this was. All right, well, we're gonna go ahead and wrap this episode up, because this has just been kind of like a get home and clean your house type deal. It was just so rough.
I'd like to thank you all for joining me for another episode of Subnautica. Once again, I am Captain Beefy, and I'm with the Game Vault here. If you haven't already, please subscribe to the channel and hit that bell for notifications. Don't forget to leave a comment down below and a like on the video. The likes are a huge help. And feel free to share on social media so other people can become part of the family here. I appreciate all the support. I'll see you next time. Stay dry.